the effectiveness of speech is rapidly dwindling. We need to experience the perfect no for ourselves. The perfect no says, no, we cannot die. We can dream of nightmares of death, on and on and on and on and on, but that has no effect on what we are. The perfect no is within all of us, placed there by the Holy Spirit, the grace of God. It's within our minds. It's within the mind. It's within the one mind that we all share. It is within the one mind that we all share. We need only to turn our attention to that perfect no and experience it beyond words. We are not trying to worship anything, not trying to worship a teacher, a guru. We're trying to be reassured. We're allowing ourselves to be reassured that we can, yes, we can turn our attention to the no, we can't die. The proper use of yes, we can is a yes, we can turn our attention to the perfect no. And there's nothing else to be done except to do it, to dive in, as it were. Fortunately, we have a representation here of the perfect no. Seamless focus on the perfect no. Existence is really an attempt on our part, the part of spirit, to learn how to die. Of course, that makes sense. If you hear this and you say, my gosh, of course, that's what I've been doing all along. Trying to learn how to die. Thinking that it was essential that I learn this. At least telling myself, this is essential. You must do this. These are just motivational tactics to try and get us to learn how to die. And why are we trying to learn how to die? So that we can be greater than God, plain and simple. at some point we realize that we've simply been trying to motivate ourselves by telling ourselves lies, saying that this is essential, we must do this. All we're left with, really, is a continuity problem. And the perfect no is the resolution to the continuity problem. There's nothing that needs to be accomplished. The perfect no is already within us. We just need to turn our attention to the perfect no. And once we have done that, we need to deflect the demand that somehow we concentrate it somehow. Condense it so there's more of the perfect no somewhere and less of the perfect no elsewhere, as it were. The ego will say, great, now put this perfect no into formations. But the perfect no is the absence of those formations in terms of meaning. The perfect no permeates all formations equally. And we have one here. A formation, an appearance to us, yet the consciousness attached to this formation is hearing and seeing and experiencing the perfect no reverberating equally through all formations. No formation introduces distortion into the perfect no. No formation amplifies it or condenses it. And the ego insists, well, it must be something special somewhere, because it doesn't want the continuity problem to be solved. Because the resolution of the continuity issue means we don't need the ego anymore. we can talk about the perfect no in various ways. You might say it's a sound like an om, a beautiful sound or tone, equally heard everywhere. It's not louder one place and softer in another. It's not echoing anywhere. It's perfect saturation, a seamless saturation. And the ego will say, but there's no special concentration anywhere. And we'll say, there's no self there. There's no I there. But it's really the ego saying that it's not there. There's no place for the ego to operate. It's complaining. There's no specialness in reality. The resolution of the continuity problem reminds us of reality, so much so that we're able to then be willing to set perception down and say, no problem. No fear of loss of continuity because I've been reminded of reality. No specialness. There's no part of reality that is more true than another part. No part of reality is more true than another facet of it. It's all one truth, all sharing the same truth, the same functionality, the same laws, the same freedom, the same eternal life. There's not some part of reality that is endless and some other part that is not endless. Okay? So there's no specialty, no duality in reality. So the resolution of the continuity problem, the seamless saturation that we experience, the perfect no, is just like that, perceptually. And perception can take on different forms, like auditory, visual. We might have some synesthesia sense of hearing and seeing and smelling and feeling it, you know, and tasting it all at once, as it were. But a seamless saturation, no specialness, no duality to it. So these are the times where we might as well jump. We might as well jump into it. What are we jumping into? Simply the seamlessness of it. The seamless saturation. That's all. Are we lost in that? Well, if we think of ourselves as a concentration of something, an accumulation of something, then it will seem like we've lost ourselves. But keep in mind that this seamless saturation is simply the means whereby we're reminded of reality so we can set down perception. Since there's no specialness in reality, we don't need to be reminded of a special self. We no longer need to be reminded of that. A concentration, as it were, a special concentration, a special accumulation, a formulation that has more. So even though we can continue to perceive qualities in all the formations, we are simultaneously experiencing this seamless saturation that is equally permeating all formations. And so that is how we can be in the world but not of it. Now the one that we are in the presence of, looking at, watching, experiencing here, was and still is an imperfect embodiment of the perfect no. Perfect embodiment of the perfect no, the perfect presence of the perfect no. Flawless, seamless presence of the seamless saturation, the perfect no. So simply a reassurance device. Now this reassurance device dropped the body, the gross body, in 1982, but is still in the subtle body. Is still in the subtle body. So we use this expedient to help us focus in reassurance, seamless saturation, perfect, equal saturation, no amplification, no distortion, no accumulation, and we are seeing here it is possible to be in this world and also simultaneously experience this seamless saturation of the perfect no. Absolutely possible to do this. So, yes, we can get to know we can't. And that resolves level confusion for us. Yes, we can get to know we can't. The perfect saturation with no special qualities. The seamless saturation with no special qualities. Simultaneously being experienced as we continue to perceive the world around us and all the formations and the qualities that they have. We're still entirely functional. Just as we may be listening to a song on headphones and still very much aware of the world around us. And all we have to do is simply notice that there is this seamless saturation taking place. Simply notice it. It's called abiding in it. Some say abiding in the self or the seamless saturation. Abiding in it, simply noticing that this is the case. That's all. We don't have to compute anything. Simply notice it. We don't have to write poems about it. We don't have to worship it. We don't have to do anything at all about it. We simply need to notice it and notice this is a fact. Just be honest and say, wow, this is a fact. this seamless saturation is, you know, permeates this refrigerator and the wall and the ceiling and the airspace and the knives and the bread and the radio and the picture frame and the hat and the light and the computer. Everything is equally saturated. There's no special saturation, nothing being left out. There is nothing being left out. Equal saturation, seamless, no parts to it. Nothing being left out. Simply notice this fact. And be reassured that this one that we're looking at is perfectly aware and is experiencing this very fact. Is experiencing this very fact that all things in existence seamlessly saturated at all moments. This one is simply noticing this fact. That's all. Simply notice this fact. That's all.